District play in Texas high school football is starting to take a little bit of shape, and we have a couple bye weeks this week, but that doesn't mean that there's still not a lot of exciting play this week. I'm Travis Brown. This is Ryan Osborne, DFWVarsity.com, and welcome to the High School Huddle. Let's start out with an epic moment from last week and a historical moment from last week as Fort Worth Arlington Heights went out to California, first Texas team to go play football in California, and beat Scotts Valley 28-14 in a pretty dominating performance, it seems like.
A solid win for Heights, especially considering that the week, this was a 5 to 6 day trip. They got out there last Wednesday. They toured the new 49ers stadium. They went to a Stanford game. They went to the beach. They even went to classes with Scotts Valley players. Mm-hmm. So sort of an extracurricular trip too, in addition to football. But to get a win, get to 3-0, heading into district play, a district that Heights and South Hills, it should come down to one of those two teams if things go as planned. But yeah, the first Texas team to go to California. I think we were just talking. It's surprising that it's never happened before. But also, there's sort of that aura of Texas high school football that these California teams are intrigued by. So they come out here a lot, but also I think they wanted to get them out there for their fans. I think there's over 1,000 fans, which I think for California games is a pretty sizable amount compared to what, you know, in Texas you'll see 1,000 on any given night. But California, very big deal to watch this Heights team play.
With how Texans feel about Texas and Texas high school football, yeah, it's definitely a study abroad trip.
Yes.
Let's go right into actually Fort Worth Arlington Heights' next game. They take on Grapevine at Fort Worth's Farrington Field. What do you see in this matchup? Grapevine looking for that first win. Arlington Heights has been rolling through their play so far. Is this maybe one where Grapevine can steal one?
I think Grapevine is an improved team. I think they were winless last year, or maybe won one game in 6A. They dropped down a class, and they should be improved, but I think Heights should win this game. If Heights were to lose this game, it's not going to derail their season because it is a non-district game. For Grapevine, it would be a great win, but I'm going to pick Heights because I just think that they kind of have the momentum going right now. And Grapevine, with new coach Randy Jackson, I think it's going to take some time for them to – I think they'll pick up a few wins in that district that they're in with some Fort Worth schools, but I think Heights is one of the better Fort Worth schools and should handle Grapevine this week.
With what Randy Jackson did at Poteet before, in a very similar situation, a program that was losing a lot before, I'm always expecting to see that win turn into another win. They just need to get that first win. I don't think it's going to be this week, but once they get that first win, I kind of expect to maybe see a little bit of a snowball, or maybe that might not even be until next season. But I think that Grapevine is in the right direction. I think Arlington Heights will win this one. Also next, we have Arlington Bowie at Colleyville Heritage.
This should be a high-scoring game. Heritage, we don't know too much about them. They're 2-1. They beat Lake Highlands last week, and so that was a solid win. But they have a new coach too. I think Bowie will win this game. They have the speed. They even kept up with Cedar Hill for at least a quarter or two a couple weeks ago. I think they coming off the bye week, they get a solid win, then go into district play where they're going to be. It's going to be them and Martin, per usual, in that Arlington district. So I think the Vols get a win going into district.
I think it's surprising to say that, to even think about the fact that Arlington Bowie is one of the best passing teams,
yes,
in the area right now. With Tony James, it really improved his passing over the summer. They have 3 wide receivers over 100 yards receiving in 2 games, and 2 over 200 yards receiving. So it's interesting to see the kind of passing attack they have, and I think it'll be more than Colleyville Heritage can handle. And finally, we have Mansfield Lake Ridge, a very impressive Mansfield Lake Ridge over their first couple of games at Lancaster, which is always a powerhouse.
I think Lancaster will win this game. Lancaster, they were up on Trinity 7-0 last week. They're very fast, very, like you said, a powerhouse program in Class 5A. But Lake Ridge is very improved. They even hung around with Fossil Ridge a couple weeks ago. Ended up being a big win for Fossil Ridge, but also Lake Ridge. They're, I believe, their third year as a program, third or fourth year. A much improved last season, going to be more improved this year. I think they should at least hang with Lancaster and show that this is a team in a Mansfield district that is full of talent, and that they got a lot of the talent that Timberview had, or at least was in Timberview's district when that school opened. So I think Lake Ridge will hang with Lancaster. Lancaster will eventually, I think, probably pull away and win this game. But we want to watch out for this game, because this could be a measuring stick for Lake Ridge going into their district play, what should be a competitive District 15 5A.
Right. Lancaster showed me a lot in that loss to Trinity. I mean, we always talk about teams. We usually always go to Trinity because teams can't handle that kind of size and power that Trinity has. And I think Lancaster's a really good team. I'm going to go with Lancaster in this one. No huddle real quick. DeSoto versus... Steele down from San Antonio.
Great game in a Baylor's McLean Stadium. I'm going to go with DeSoto, though.
I'm going to go DeSoto as well. Mansfield Timberview at versus Arlington Seguin.
Seguin is a solid program, but I think Timberview is the class of 5A teams in DFW. I think they get the win.
I agree. I'm going with Timberview as well. Cedar Hill at Coppell.
Cedar Hill, this is speed versus power. I think Cedar Hill wants to avenge a loss to Dallas Skyline last week.
Exactly, and Coppell's kind of been a little bit shaky to me. I'd definitely take Cedar Hill in this one. Hewless Trinity at Glenda Park North Shore.
Power football between two powerhouse programs. I think Trinity goes on the road and gets a win, but this should be one of the best games in the state all week.
I'll go with Trinity as well, and Birdville at Abilene Wiley.
Birdville with a huge win over Nelson to get off that 0-2 mark. I think they win again, keep that momentum going against a pretty solid 4A program in Wiley.
This is a pretty vanilla show. I'm going to go with Birdville as well. Right. And real quick, we're going to go to our play of the week. Arlington Millar's Kofi Botang with a 47-yard pass reception from Shane Buchel. He wraps his arms around the defender, somehow manages to pull this catch in. It was a very impressive play, so tip of the cap to Kofi at Arlington Lamar for that catch.
Yeah, it was a great catch, almost like the Tyrone Prothro for Alabama made almost 8 or so years ago around the defender. It was even on USA Today's high school page. So this thing went nationwide, went viral, and props to that young man for heck of a catch.
Exactly. Well, we have a great slate again this week. Go out and catch a game. Check DFWVarsity.com for the best recaps and stats, and we'll see you next week on the High School Huddle.